Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see the details on Google Admin Toolbox applications. Google Admin Toolbox enables setup tools for admins to troubleshoot issues with Google Workspace. The tools can be used by administrators to troubleshoot the general issues. Let us see the list of tools. The first one is Browser Info. This tool helps to collect the important browser parameters, example language, encoding, etc. Also checks if your browser has any connectivity issue. Let us quickly review the tool. All the tools can be accessed through this specific URL, toolbox.googleapps.com, then apps main. So let me click on this. This is the first tool, Browser Info. Let me click on this. This will display all the important parameters. You can see IP address, user agent, then language, cookies, screen resolution, encoding, keep alive, all those important parameters. The parameters can be reviewed to identify the issues that might impact the user experience. Also, this will verify for any firewall related issues. If you see here, you can see the firewall. So they are like whether the connectivity is success based on the firewall rule. The next one is CheckMX. This analyzes the public DNS records of a domain for common MX record misconfigurations related to Google Mail servers. Let us quickly see the tool. Click on this, CheckMX. Then enter your domain. Then click on Run Checks. This will show you the issues related to MX records, email configurations, specific to the Google email servers. Yeah, this is listing out all the configuration detail here. So if there is any issue, it will list out so that we can address those issues. The next one is Message Header. This analyzes email message headers to look for the cause of mail delivery delays. So let's see how to use that tool. If I go here again, yeah, you can see message header. Now paste the email header here. So let me show you how to get that header. If I go to Gmail, so here you can click on this more. Then there is a click on this option. So original, then yeah, then you can copy this to clipboard. Come back here and paste it. Now analyze this header above. It will show you all the details, when time received and all those details. So if there is a delay, it's in 37 seconds. This will be useful to identify the delay, so where the delay is happening. The next one is Log Analyzer. This analyzes locally stored log files to explain errors in the below Google products. Chrome OS devices, then Google App Directory Sync, then Google Apps Migration for Microsoft Outlook, some more products. Next one is Log Analyzer 2. This tool opens large log files generated by Google products and diagnose common problems on those tools. Access the tools through these URLs, Log Analyzer and Log Analyzer 2. Let me click on that. Let me go to Log Analyzer. Here you can paste the logs. Refer these links for the details on generating the logs for different Google products. Yeah, then select this log source. Even it will auto detect, or even you can select this, then you can analyze it. So same way, you go to this Log Analyzer 2. Here you can choose the file, also it's auto detect, or you can even select the product type and analyze the logs. Yeah, in the Log Analyzer, even you can choose file. If the file is small size, if it is a larger size, you can go for Log Analyzer 2. Here you can just click on choose file. You will be able to select the log file. The next one is HAR Analyzer. HAR Analyzer is an online tool visualizing HTTP archive files produced by browser. The details are discussed in another video. So refer this URL for more details on HAR file and how to analyze the HAR file for debugging the issues. What is HAR? HTTP archive file, and how to use HAR file for debugging the issues. The tool can be accessed through this. Come here and click on this HAR analyzer. Then you can load the HTTP archive files generated through browsers. The next one is D command. Helps you check the domain DNS information. This can be used as a web-based equivalent of the Unix D command. Let us quickly see the tool. Yeah, you can access the tool from here. Dig. Yeah, then just enter the domain name, then you should be able to see all the DNS records. A record, then CNAME, MX, SOA, then TXT record details. The next one is encode/decode toolset. This provides you different encoding and decoding functions. Let us quickly see that. If I come here, then yeah, you can access the tool from here, encode/decode. So let me access that. There are multiple options, base64 encode decode, then base64 URL encode decode, then URL encode decode, MD5 hash, SAML encode decode, even JSON formatting, then UTF-16 decode. There are multiple options. So maybe you can enter the data, then you can select the function, let's say MD5 hash, then you can say just to submit, it will give the data. Same way like other functions, you can use it. There are some additional tools. You can refer from here, additional tools. Let me click on that. Flush the Google public DNS. This flush the DNS cache for a domain in the Google public DNS cache. You can configure your system to use Google public DNS to resolve the IP address for a domain. Most of the cases, the system uses ISP's domain name server through the dynamic host configuration protocol. These are the IP address for the Google public DNS. You can configure in your system. Even you can use IPv6 values. So let me open the tool. Enter the domain name to flush the hash. So let me enter. It's fine. Flush. Yeah, it's success. So even you can change the record type, CNAME or SOA or whatever the record type you need to flush, we can set that. To change the DNS server details in Windows, go to search, click on the Windows button, then here you type network, click on view network connections. You can see all the available network connections. Select the one you are using. I am using this one. Right click, properties. Then here you select internet protocol version 4, IPv4. Even you can select IPv6 if you are using that. I am not using that. So let me go here. Then click on properties. So here you can see obtain DNS server address automatically. So this is through DHCP server and it uses the ISP's domain name server. So we can select this, use the following DNS server addresses. Here we can set the Google's public DNS server details, the preferred DNS server and alternate DNS server. So Google provides two IP address, so we can set those values over here. After the system uses Google public DNS to resolve the DNS to IP addresses. Whenever required, we can use that tool to flush the DNS cache. Read on the details on other tools. Here multiple tools are there, like this all more than tools. These are all troubleshooting steps, how to troubleshoot Gmail errors, diagnose Chrome connectivity. There are multiple topics, you can read through this. Google Admin Toolbox enables some of the useful tools for admins. This can be used by admins for troubleshooting different issues. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.